In considering their overall performance at the Rio Olympics, it is pertinent to observe that this was a history-making appearance since 1980, as it marked the first time football in general and Mighty Warriors in particular have qualified for a major international footballing tournament. Whilst the arithmetic permutations emanating from the field of play were understandably unfavorable to the football-loving fans of the Mighty Warriors, it should not be lost to the discerning minds that this was a David and Goliath engagement. Since the arrival of the Mighty Warriors yesterday afternoon, various media have been awash with allegations pertaining to how they were received. Allegations that the Mighty Warriors were not received by Zifa and Zog are inaccurate. Zifa and Zog, as well as multitudes of fans, were present at the airport to receive the Mighty Warriors. The Zimbabwe Olympic Committee, represented by Mrs. Chieza Mafunga and Mrs. Piwa Nyamande, whilst Zifa was represented by Mr. Philip Chiangwa, Mr. Felton Kamambo, both of whom are Zifa board members, while the Zifa secretariat was present in the persons of Mrs. Maguranyanga and Mr. Gwesele. In this regard, we need to note that organizational issues after departure from the airport into town and thereafter to their respective individual destinations was a matter for ZOC to handle, working in collaboration with Zifa. The public spectacle surrounding the management of this aspect in general and the handling of allowances in particular was unfortunate and admittedly indecorous given the valiant performance of our Mighty Warriors in Rio. The digression from the agreed ZOC and Zifa itinerary that led to the team being diverted to Daisy Lodge needs urgent clarification. This is in light of information obtained from Zifa that accommodation had been arranged at a local hotel here in Harare. We have asked both Zifa and ZOC to provide such information. The Minister of Sports and Recreation would like to state and point out the following. Prior to the departure of Team Zimbabwe for the 2016 Rio Summer Olympics, the Minister of Sport and Recreation released US$90,000 for Team Zimbabwe, which comprised of 31 delegates covering various sporting codes, including women's football. It is trite, therefore, to note that on the basis of the principle of equal treatment, all athletes belonging to Team Zimbabwe were paid US$500 by ZOC as partial payment in the context of the available resources. In view of the foregoing, it is therefore patently inaccurate that the Mighty Warriors, who are an integral part of Team Zimbabwe, were not paid at all for their participation at the Rio Olympics. I spoke of partial payment that was received by the athletes because in terms of what we requested for from Treasury, we got only 90,000 and we are still waiting disbursement of a further 100,000, which again is supposed to go towards the games and the athletes. So I'm very clear of what I'm talking about, and we're just awaiting the disbursement of those funds. But my officers and treasury officers are busy working on that with a view to coming up with a resolution on the matter as quickly as possible. And we have asked the chef de mission to provide a report as well as ZOC and Zifa, so that we can reconcile and mediate, the differences where they lie. But it is our view also that given the facts that we have, issues in women football in particular have to be resolved as far as the governance structures of women football is concerned. It is government's considered view that the fissures within the structures of football in general and women's football in particular, are now impacting negatively on the sports brand in Zimbabwe. The protracted contestation of a leadership within the governance structures of women football in Zimbabwe requires urgent resolution by Zifa, as it seems to partly inform and or sponsor the current narrative. In tandem with the undulating policy and strategy of sport and recreation, Minister of Sport and Recreation will, within the next few days, announce a team to spearhead and coordinate the establishment of a fully fledged athletes commission that will encapsulate all stakeholders with a view to give heightened focus on the welfarist aspects of our athletes, including their conditions of service. Once again, the minister warmly welcomes our Mighty Warriors home and salutes them for their trailblazing appearance at the Rio Olympics. We wish the rest of the team Zimbabwe the best of luck. I thank you.
Kana muchida kuvewo kutanga kunzwa nyaya dzakadai mazuva ese garai makateya pa YouTube nekuklika button rakanzi subscribe munobva maitawo kutanga pa ZimdiTv News kunzwa zvirikuitika.